Today we're talking about Ireland, an island that is super ironically half United Kingdom and half independent republic. Not the most united part of the kingdom. Although, if you try to change that, you'll quickly learn that an Irish gar bomb is not just a drink. So why are we talking about Ireland today? I mean, I could be making an almost identical Ukraine episode to the one I dropped last week. Well, the reason is, in a Hail Mary attempt to avoid a no-deal Brexit, yesterday Boris Johnson proposed a new way of handling this international border. The questions I'm going to try to answer today are, what makes this border so controversial? How does the current Theresa May framework agreement handle this border? And lastly, how is Boris Johnson proposing to change that? So let's get started. The Irish border, the best evidence that, if you're gonna do imperialism, don't do it to your next door neighbor. It's like dating a coworker. If things don't end well, you're not going anywhere. Right now, you have the United Kingdom that is currently Brexiting, hanging out in the upper right-hand corner of Ireland, and the Republic of Ireland that is firmly part of the European Union, making up the majority of this area. You terrified yet? Ooh, the United Kingdom has a land border with the European Union. So spooky. The problem begins with the concept that Americans debate a lot right now. Open borders. This border is the textbook definition of an open border right now.
On the way to Brexit, the biggest roadblock we face, the Irish border.
That's it. We've just crossed the border. Ireland to Northern Ireland. No markings. Just the signs change.
So how did it get this way? Well, it was a pretty multi-decade, pretty terrorist-y war between Protestant UK nationalists who were fighting to remain in the UK and the Catholic separatists who wanted to join the independent Republic of Ireland. Of course, in classic British understating, this war is now referred to as the Troubles. Well, that's not patronizing. The important point is, it was resolved in 1998 when Ireland, Northern Ireland, and the UK all sat down to finally hash this thing out. The major part of the agreement that's relevant to this conversation was that all sides said that there was going to be an open border between Northern Ireland and Ireland. Now don't worry, I'm not just giving you random history here, I'm building to something. The logical question is, if all these groups were able to agree on an open border back in 1998, why would this Brexit change things? Well, one of the major reasons they were able to agree on such a deal was something very significant that happened 5 years earlier.
In 1993, the Maastricht Treaty officially renamed the EEC as the European Union and introduce more cooperation between governments.
For the purposes of this episode, that agreement brought Britain and Ireland into the European Common Market and the European Customs Union, which meant that all of the goods that were passing through the borders were held to an identical regulatory standard, and they didn't have to pass through customs. It also meant that there would be guaranteed free trade between Britain and Ireland, so, you know, no need to put up a toll on that border. Now that the United Kingdom is announcing that the EU isn't the boss of them anymore, they're gonna write their own trade regulations. This unfortunately means that now we have a piece of land that's half regulated by common European product regulations and half governed by this totally rebellious and, come on, how radically different could it really be, UK product regulations. We have to keep these pesky European quality standards out of our British economy. It's good enough for France, but maybe it's not good enough for me. If this sounds like an incredibly mundane revelation because, oh man, turns out this huge point of contention comes down to slight differences in product regulation, just know that, and while the problem isn't dramatic, the battle over the solutions definitely is. So let's start with Theresa May. How would she regulate the flow of goods between the two Irelands?
What has now emerged is the idea that an option to extend the implementation period could be a further solution to this issue of the backstop in Northern Ireland.
All right, so I heard words, but what did any of that mean? Well, as soon as they even start to describe it, you'll quickly see why Boris Johnson wants to scrap this entire deal. UK Prime Minister Theresa May's Brexit deal avoids the reintroduction of a so-called hard Irish border because of the built-in transition period that keeps the UK in a customs union with the EU. Alright, so because the UK will remain in the EU's customs union until 2020, they won't have to worry about a difference in product regulations. Problem averted. Britain will just keep using the European standards and stay in the customs union. One question though. A crucial part of a transition period is a different endpoint. What happens in 2020 when Britain is scheduled to leave that customs union? The problem comes if there's no agreement on what to do after the transition period that ends in 2020. Enter the Irish Backstop, an insurance policy designed to avoid a hard border if no other solution to police the border are found by that time. Now this is where things start to get really out there. Miss May agreed to a backstop involving the whole of the UK retaining a very close relationship with the EU, staying in the customs union for an indefinite period. See, a solution to the problem with no obvious solution is just push it down the road and stay in a customs union you now have no influence over. Until, of course, you figure out something else. Independence. So that's the deal to beat. Boris Johnson, do you have any ideas? Well, today we saw his plan.
Boris Johnson has presented his final proposal for a new Brexit deal to the EU. It brings Great Britain out of the EU, but keeps Northern Ireland in the EU single market for 4 years to smooth over the transition. This would create two borders for a period of 4 years. There would be a sea regulatory border between mainland Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and a customs border between Northern Ireland and the Republic of Ireland.
Oh no, we're splitting up the United Kingdom! This new deal, proposed on October 2nd, would force Northern Ireland to stay with the EU for 4 years, while mainland Britain can start regulating their own goods and just go crazy with regulation. At the end of those 4 years, I'm just guessing, Northern Ireland will probably continue to be in that trade union, because we're already planning a second deal when the first one's going on 3 years. More specifically, the plan would be underpinned by the approval of the Northern Irish Assembly, which would get to vote on whether to keep the two-border agreement or align more closely with the UK rules, hardening the border with Ireland every 4 years. Basically, every 4 years, Northern Ireland's Congress gets to vote on whether to violate the peace treaty that resolved decades of violence or stay with EU trade regulations. So all of that is pretty palatable. Here's Britain's special sauce that makes this entire thing incredibly unpalatable. Northern Ireland would be leaving the EU customs union along with the rest of the UK. Now that might seem to contradict everything I just said, but bear with me. For this hypothetical, assume Mexico has the exact same regulations on goods that America does. Think of this as transitioning your border from a border between California and Nevada to the border between California and this hypothetical, equally regulated Mexico. The fact that the regulations are consistent between the two countries will help speed up trade, but you're gonna want a guy keeping track of these foreign imports.
There will have to be a system for customs checks away from the border. Now, we think that those checks can be absolutely minimal and non-intrusive and won't involve new infrastructure.
Basically, this would mean a customs border between Northern Ireland and Ireland, which Johnson said could be managed through electronic checks and far from the border and physical checks at the premises of traders, as well as other sites that could be located anywhere in Northern Ireland or Ireland. So maybe if you live in a Northern Irish border town, you might be able to get your hands on those sweet, sweet Euro goods. But inside the border, all of that is getting checked. Still, technically an open border, as the checks aren't happening at the physical border. So alright, this might sound all needlessly arbitrary. Why would Boris Johnson want Northern Ireland to abide by EU regulations but leave the customs union? To just trigger the Europeans and make sure this deal gets rejected? Well, not quite. Johnson says that the UK must exit the customs union whole and entirely to allow it to pursue future trade deals for the entire country. Again, this is where things get a little stroke-inducing. Pause the video if you start to smell burnt toast. Actually, just mute it. I could really use the boost to viewer retention. If Northern Ireland were to remain in the customs union, they'd be kinda like Turkey. Turkey, which is a partial customs union member with the EU, has to follow EU trade agreements with third countries, but has no say on them. The reality is that, in a customs union, all the power would rest with the EU, with Ireland as a follower. This would mean that if Northern Ireland stays in the customs union, their trade agreements would all be at the whim of Europe, while mainland Britain would be wheeling and dealing on their own, or flailing in the wind, depending on how bad you think Brexit will be on British trade prospects.
We are entitled to protect our customs union, and we are entitled to exit as a sovereign state.
This is a radical departure from Theresa May's deal we talked about earlier in the episode, that would see the entire UK staying in the customs union until they found a solution to this Irish border. This, of course, brings us to the final question of the episode. Hey EU, why are you so opposed to Northern Ireland leaving the customs union? All I can say right now is EU President Sebastian Juncker has stressed that any solutions must meet the EU's objectives of preventing a hard border in Ireland, preserving cooperation between Northern Ireland and the Republic, and protecting the EU's single market. This isn't to say that any of these are deal breakers, as over the next few weeks, the EU will get together and see if they accept this new deal. But these are the factors they're going to be considering when going over the deal. So that's exactly what's going on with Boris Johnson's Brexit proposal right now. Thank you, and that's definitely not all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, quick FYI, starting October 10th, I'm going to be going backpacking with my mom through the countryside for about 10 days. So don't worry, I'm not going soft on you and I stopped posting videos for about 2 weeks. Back to my normal spiel now. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.